Hi, my name is Stefan Chiri, and I'm the head of IT here at Minerva. And today in this video, I'll be demonstrating how to install Aras Innovator in the cloud. All right, here I am in the Google Cloud platform, and we want to go to Compute Engine VM Instances. We want to click Create. We want to give our instance a name. And select in which region the server is located. In this case, I'm selecting Frankfurt because that is pretty close to my own location. The next thing we want to do is select the machine type, meaning the capacity of the machine that we want to instantiate. And in this case, I'm selecting 4 CPUs and 16 gigs of RAM. The next thing we want to select is the operating system. And as you can see, Google has a lot of different operating systems to select from. But they also have a different option, which is application image. Since we also need a database, we can do it more specifically by selecting the application images. The database that we're looking for is an SQL server. And if we use the Express version, we don't have to pay the license fee. Now, the Express version is limited to only 10 gigabytes, but that is fine for the test instance that we are setting up. Now what we need to do is set up security settings, and if we select these default settings down here, that will open up our instance to the entire internet, and we might not necessarily want to do that, so we'll wait configuring that. We hit create, and now our server instance is already being created for us. All right, so now we want to set up security. We go to view network details. And as you can see here, we've not allowed any traffic outside of this instance, and we need to allow some kind of access from our home office. We go to firewall rules, create new firewall rule, give it a name, and we only want to allow access from our home office. So we go down to all instances in the network. We set the source IP to be the IP address of our home office. And then we say allow all and create. All right, that has been added. So now we can access our instance. Now what we want to do is we want to access our instance by going to remote desktop protocol, and we want to download the remote desktop protocol. We want to set the Windows password for the current user and copy that to the clipboard. So now when we click on the RDP file we just downloaded, we get the security prompt where we can paste in the password that we were just given. And now we're logged into the server. All right, so now we have our server up and running. Now you can go to aras.com/support to download Aras Innovator and to download the installation instructions on how to install it. For this video, I've prepared 2 automatic scripts that will do everything for us automatically. So we start up our PowerShell prompt as administrator, and I'll put a link to an article where we have these scripts so you can just copy and paste these in. The second thing we want to do is we want to open up a command prompt and also paste in a script that has been pre-prepared. This script downloads a packet manager called Chocolate, and Chocolate will make sure that all our prerequisites are installed. One thing you'll notice is that the last prerequisite is a program called Notepad, and that is because we need to edit a configuration file as the final step. All right, now we've installed all the prerequisites and downloaded Innovator. And since the PowerShell script has downloaded Innovator, I now have the MSI file in this install folder. So I just hit the I key and press tab twice, and I'll get the MSI file. The installation of Aras is a wizard that I'll be going through quite quickly, but I just want to pause a few places and make some comments. So this question is, do I have access to a database, and do I have all my prerequisites installed? And I click yes to that. The last question is, do I have a license key for the Aras Innovator? Now, at the moment, I don't, but I'm just gonna click yes, because there is a request button right here on the wizard itself. If I click that request button, it's going to take me into a browser. Now, the browsers on web servers, or the browser on servers in general, are quite limited in what they can actually access. Everything is pretty much locked down. So there's going to be a lot of security warnings that we have to click OK to. The only thing that we want to look out for is this one. Content from this website is listed as blocked, aras.com. So what we want to do here is we want to click add. Add that to the list of trusted websites, and then close this. So now we can actually see the content of this web page. The rest of the content, we don't need to worry about that. All right. So right now, the install wizard has pre-configured the server MAC address. So all we need to do now is just to fill out the rest of this little sign-up form here. I have already done this, so it will recognize me when I click the Look Me Up button. And in fact, it will just immediately send me to this confirmation page and tell me that it has sent my login details or my license key to my email address. Now, you'll notice that this page looks kind of dull, and that is because all the stylings and that has been blocked by security settings on my server. All right, within 5 to 10 seconds, I will receive my license key in my email, and I can then go back to my installation wizard. All of these settings, I'll just leave them as default, but you can review all these screens here and change the settings that you want to change. I'll do a complete installation, and again, I'm just accepting all the standard locations and standard naming of the wizard. Now, this is an example of a license key that is not filled out, but the email I just received contains the license key, so I'll just paste that over the text that is already there and hit next. This is the web alias that our Aras Innovator instance will be the name that instance will get. So make a note of this name right here, and you can change it if you want. I'm just gonna accept Innovator Server as the web alias. So now we're at the database configuration screen, and there's one setting that I need to make in my database before I can continue. So in order to do that, I need to access my server management studio, and the easiest way to find it is by hitting the Windows key and typing in SSMS for SQL Server Management Studio. All right, this is our server name, and we are logging in using Windows authentication, so we just hit connect. Right now, our database server is empty, but the setting that we need to change is the login. So we go to properties on the top node here, go down to security, and then in server authentication, we select SQL Server and Windows authentication mode and click OK. So what this is telling me is that I need to restart my server for this change to take effect. I right click on the top node, go to restart, accept the prompts that I'm presented with, and then we're good to go. All right, so now we're back in the wizard. We want to select Windows authentication and then provide a password for the database users. Just keep in mind that they need to be complex passwords, so they need to consist of both numbers, letters, and special characters. Otherwise, they will not be accepted. We hit configure database and say, yes, we want to proceed. And now the database is being created for us. All right, the database has been configured. And now we're back to the wizard. So now we click next. And we say install. And that will install the web application, the Innovator web application. All right, now we're done. We hit finish. And now we can access our Innovator instance in the browser by going to localhost/innovator-server. And we're all set. We now have a working installation of Aras Innovator. I can log in using the username admin and the password innovator. All right, we're logged in, and clicking this icon in the left-hand side will bring up the menu, and now we can start working and configuring our Aras installation. Okay, so now we know our web application is working and that we can access it. Now we want to access it from the outside, and we do that by minimizing the server window, opening up a browser, and unfortunately, there is one more configuration that we need to do. We will receive this error, invalid redirect URL. So there's one piece of configuration that we still need to do. So we log back into the server and we open up the Notepad++ program that was installed during the prerequisites. And then we go to the installation path where we installed Aras Innovator. Now that might be different for you, but since I selected the default, it will be in program files, Aras Innovator. And now we want to find the OAuth server directory and find the OAuth config file. Then we want to find a setting called redirect URIs. And as you can see here, the installation has been configured for localhost and then for the server name and for the internal IP. Now we will also want to configure our instance to work for the external IP. And since I will never be using the internal IP to access this instance, I'm just going to override these settings here using the external IP, and the same goes for this post logout redirect URIs. I'm just going to override these. Now, when you set up an Aras instance, probably you want to use a DNS reference, and of course, then you just add those DNS references to this list in this OAuth configuration file. So we save that. Once this configuration has been created, I just want to make sure that the server registers it, so I'm just going to restart the information server. And I do that using the IIS reset command, and you still need to be in administrative mode in the command prompt. So now that has been reset, I'm going to try to fill in the URL once again. And we're no longer seeing this error. We can log in using admin innovator, and we're good to go. That concludes this demonstration of how to install Aras Innovator in the cloud.